By what name are you known?
There are some who call me Tim.
Welcome to another episode of Timmy Talks, the channel where we talk old school magic. And welcome to another Mail Day video. So I've got two nice envelopes. One is sent to me by Petra. I have no idea what's in here. It's a complete surprise. It feels kind of thick. You don't really see it, but I can see it a little bit. It feels kind of thick. I think there's some interesting stuff in here. So I'm going to do this one last. Then I've got a mail by Ian. And I made a trade with Ian. This is mail all the way from Canada. And I send him an international edition veteran bodyguard because he collects bodyguards. And he sent me something back. So I'm going to open that right now. Why wait? And this is actually a card for my beta blue deck, which is still in the making, and I promise I'll show it here on the channel once it's done. Because I've been getting some questions, when are you actually going to show the deck? I will, but I need to get stuff out of sleeves, put stuff into sleeves, you know how it goes. Okay, so here's a letter. So I'm just going to check if there's no personal information on the letter. Oh, nice, this is cool, I love this. Handwritten stuff, man, I love it. Hello, Timmy. Please return many fatties with this unsummon. Well, then you know the card. Cheers from Ontario, Canada, Ian. P.S. I write like I am five because I'm in IT. That's so cool. Look, I agree. I'm a primary school teacher and you write a little bit like you're five, but that's fine. I mean, we're typing all the time now anyway. Actually, I teach grade four and I usually tell the parents that this is one of the last moments in their life where we can kind of focus on their handwriting. So I do focus on it, but I'm a teacher. But anyway, I won't bother you guys with my philosophy on that. But what a cool note, man. I keep all these notes, by the way, like all the personal stuff. I've got a special drawer where I keep all the notes. And so thank you very much, Ian, man. And Ian is also a patron, by the way. And we have on our patron Discord, we've got a little trade channel. So I said, I'm looking for an unsummon. And he was collecting veteran bodyguards, and that's how this this deal came to be. And the unsummon, yeah, so it looks kind of nice on the front, but the back, it's pretty heavy on the back. But if we have a look, so unsummon, for people that don't know, it's one blue. This is a beta copy. You can see it when you look at the corner. So if it's an alpha copy, the corner is more rounded. Anyway, it's one blue to cast. It's a pretty good card, actually. Instant. Return a creature to its owner's hand. Enchantments on a creature or card it, so discard it, right? Unsummon cannot be played during the damage dealing phase of an attack. So the cool thing is, for example, if your opponent wants to destroy your creature, you can play an unsummon, you can save your creature. Or if your opponent plays with control magic, it's a great way against control magic. And of course, you can also use it on the creatures of your opponent. And that's how I'm kind of planning to use it, because sometimes when you play mono blue, especially just the core set, so my beta flyers deck is going to be quite slow, you know, pretty slow. So I want to use unsummons to kind of buy me time, especially when I'm facing like a turn one hippie into dark ritual. Anyway, a beautiful, beautiful card. Thank you so much, Ian, for sending it over. And I love the note, man. I love the note. So cool. I write like I'm five because I'm in IT. That is so funny. That is hysterical. Okay, then we've got this letter by Petra. Now, Petra is, you know, super, super fan of the channel. I think you always comment on the videos and I really appreciate that. It's always positive. And you've also sent a lot of stuff my way. I sent a little bit back, but it doesn't compare with the amount of things that you send my way. So thank you very much for that, Petra. It's really, really appreciated. Actually, one of the boxes that you sent me, I use to store letters in and stuff in. That's actually, you sent me a beautiful Fallen Empires box that I'm using. So I just wanted to show you. But now, the letter. We're going to open the letter. The letter. I wonder what's in here. Oh, there's a letter in the letter. So maybe I got to send this to somebody. That could also, I've done that in the past, actually. So we're going to open this up. And oh, okay. This is not a letter in a letter. This is protected. This is interesting. So how am I going to open this? That is the question. Okay, there's a little opener here. I can rip it open. This, and I have no idea what's in here. So Maybe it's not even magic related. I think it is, but who knows? Okay, let's see what else I can do. It's a little bit risky when you're opening something you don't really know what, where the cards are or where the, what it is actually. Okay, so I can rip this away. Oh, wow. Okay, I need the scissors. I didn't want to use one, but I need it. I don't want to damage anything. So let's go like this. Oh, whoa, what's in here? Ding! See a little sleeve, I think, like empty sleeves, maybe for my collection, because I talked about that I collect booster wrappers. Oh yeah, that's what it is. Look at that. Ah, that is so cool. Let's see if I can open it up a little bit more. There we go. Hello, Thomas. You once said that you don't have a Raging Bull yet. Here is the missing card with some additions. Well, actually, I do have one Raging Bull, but if it's a Raging Bull, I would really, really appreciate it because it's a beautiful card. But I cannot. The other Raging Bulls, I all gave them away to Richard, who's the organizer of the Raging Bull series. So I guess this is then a Raging Bull, which would be awesome. There's another, okay, wow, okay, multiple cards. So we're gonna have a look. I mean, you can see it's old. Oh, wow, we got some foreign cards. Yes, love it. So we got a Banalish Hero. Sweet. That is so cool. Love that stuff. And here we've got the Raging Bull. And Raging Bull, I mean, it just used to be this cheap card, one red and two from Legends, 2/2. And, you know, it's got funny flavor text because, of course, you have a grizzly bear for one green and one in the first set of Magic Alpha. But it costs a mana less and it's a 2/2. But why would you play a bull over the bear? Well, that's because bulls have more fun. Sometimes the bulls win and sometimes the bears win. But the bulls have more fun, right? So you play the bulls. And, of course, it refers to maybe a bull market. You know, so there was this guy, maybe he's still doing it, from Switzerland, who was trying to buy out all the Raging Bulls, which is, yeah, it is nuts and it's also annoying, because then if you just want to play the Bulls for flavor, you know, which is something that many of us love to do, you can no longer do it, because all of a sudden these cards have some kind of value, which is, in a way it makes sense, because it's super cool art, it's cool flavor text, but it's also kind of silly, because, I mean, it's not a good card, you know, let's be honest, but super cool, and there's a story behind it. So this is definitely gonna be part of my collection. And then, ooh, Circle Protection Black. This is actually gonna be useful. I'm gonna play this in my mono white weenie deck. I think this is Spanish, right? Todo. I think this is Spanish. Also negro, black. I think it's Spanish. But I've been wrong in the past. And, oh, we got a noted. Yeah. Okay, I have to give these to Richard because he also collects Nords. Nords super cool. And this art is super cool. Ice Age noted. One black and three to cast Summon Imp. Tap, untap target blue creature. So it goes great with the Timmy. Or, of course, in Ice Age, you would play this with Azurin Spellcaster. And then it's also a Nettling Imp. So you can tap it to force target non-wool creature to attack. So, you know, so that's pretty cool. It's a Nettling Imp and some kind of untapped blue machine, blue creature machine in one. So that's kind of funny. But the art, of course, is beautiful. Yeah, it's up to, this Nordic is up to no good. You can see that. And then look at this. This is maybe the real treasure. We got all these cool booster wrappers and a nice Ice Age box. That is sweet. And that's quite a coincidence. In the back, I just thought it would be nice to put some things in the back to show you. You know, we've got this 4th edition starter pack. They're all empty. Like there's nothing in there. So this is purely just to collect. This is a revised edition. It's really cool. So this is an Ice Age. So you would start with this. You would, when you would start Magic, you would buy this. It's a starter deck. just, you know, it had random cards in there and some lands, and you would try to build a deck from there. That's how you would start with your Magic career, with your Magic adventure. You would buy one of these decks. So beautiful. And then we also have some beautiful booster wrappers here. Oh, that's cool. I don't have this one yet. The Mana Vault. Yes, that is great. We've got some alliances. Weatherlight I don't have as well. These are the old sets, man. I remember Weatherlight coming out and I'm like, ah, man, there's too much text on the cards. And I look at the cards now. So many things have changed. Homelands, of course. I opened that on the channel not too long ago. Yeah, these are really cool Portal. I actually got some Portal product here. Where do I have it? So Portal was this special set meant for new players. So if you wanted a new person to start, like your friend or something, you could buy them like a Portal set. So this was a starter set for two players. It also included a booster pack. It's all open, like nothing is sealed anymore here. I do have some sealed boosters, by the way, not too much though, but for example, this is a sealed The Dark pack, which is pretty cool. But I'm not big on sealed because I just love playing with the cards. So I just open everything up. Same thing with graded cards. People sometimes tell me you got to grade this card or that card that I play on the channel, but I don't like that. So I like to play with my cards, but to each their own, of course. You know, if you love grading, go for it. Anyway, Petra, wow, thank you so much for sending these gems over to me. It's very, very much appreciated. Also, thank you, Ian, for the great trade. And thank you, of course, for watching another episode right here on Timmy Talks, the channel where we talk old school magic. And see you next time. Zumba Kazee!